You want smooth scroll? Forget jQuery, we're past that. Let me introduce you to our tools for native smooth scroll. The CSS scroll behavior property accepts one of three values, or two actually, since one of those was deprecated. Auto is the default instant scrolling behavior that we're already used to. And instant is the same, which is why it was deprecated. If you want it, just use auto. Now, smooth is what we want. It applies a smooth transition when a scroll event is programmatically triggered. I say programmatically triggered because it's not going to smooth scroll the mouse wheel. Some ways of programmatically triggering a scroll event are through scroll by, scroll to, scroll into view, and setting the scroll left and scroll top properties. We'll explore these methods individually. Oh, maybe you've noticed that I haven't mentioned the scroll method. That's because Windows Scroll and Element Scroll are effectively the same methods as Windows Scroll 2 and Element Scroll 2. To avoid duplicate content, I'll just refer to Scroll 2. In practice, you can use either, just choose one and be consistent. Windows Scroll 2 and Element Scroll 2 are ideal for scrolling to absolute coordinates. If you have the X and Y coordinates for where you want to scroll the user to, you can simply call Windows Scroll 2, give it X, Y, and it will respect the CSS scroll behavior of the page. The same applies for scrollable elements. You simply call element scroll 2, give it X, Y, and it will respect the CSS scroll behavior of the element. There's also a new signature for this method, which uses an object instead of two numeric arguments. And with this new signature, we can explicitly set our scroll behavior. Setting the element scroll left and scroll top properties is the same as calling element scroll 2 with the coordinates. It will respect the CSS scroll behavior of the element. And be aware, if the direction of your element's text is right to left, scroll left 0 marks the rightmost position of horizontal scroll, and the value decreases as you go left. For a scrollable element with 100 pixels of width, 500 pixels of scrollable width, and direction right to left, the leftmost position is scroll left minus 400. Windows Scroll By and Element Scroll By has the exact same signatures as Windows Scroll 2 and Element Scroll 2. It accepts either X and Y as two numeric arguments or a single argument, being an object with the optional left, top, and behavior properties. The difference here is that we're not passing absolute coordinates, but relative values instead. If we scroll by top 10, we're scrolling down 10 pixels from where we currently are, not 10 pixels down from the beginning of the page. Firefox goes a little further by implementing methods to scroll by an amount of lines or pages. It's a non-standard feature that really only works on Firefox, so you probably don't want to use it in production. You can achieve a similar effect in all major browsers by converting 100 viewport height for a page and 1 ramp for a line to pixels and passing that value to Windows Scroll By. Most of the time, though, we don't really care about any hard-coded coordinates. We just want to scroll the user to a specific element on the page. This can easily and more explicitly be done with element scroll into view. This method can be called with no arguments, and that will scroll the page, respecting the CSS scroll behavior, until the element is aligned at the top, unless the element is at the bottom of the page. In that case, it will try to scroll as much as possible. You can further customize the element's placement in the view by passing a boolean or an object. When using an object to define the element's placement, note that block refers to the vertical placement, and inline refers to the horizontal placement. Also, the nearest placement can be the top left or the bottom right, whichever is nearest, and it can also be nothing if the element's already into view. Regarding browser support, as of this writing, all major browsers, except Safari, support smooth scroll and the scrolling methods described in this video. If you need more reassurance, there's a very good smooth scroll polyfill that I use in my projects. The polyfill scroll, scroll to, scroll by, scroll into view, and the CSS scroll behavior property. It does not support smooth scrolling by setting the scroll left and scroll top properties, and it also does not support the multiple options for the scroll into view function. It always aligns the element at the top. If you have more curiosity, I highly suggest studying the polyfill's source code. It's less than 500 lines in total. I made a PR to slightly improve the docs. you might find the code easier to understand with it. References for everything I've said are in the description below. Have a great day, and I'll see you soon.